Ever since we opened our doors in 1964, Davis Ford in Fulton has been committed to providing the highest level of customer service and customer satisfaction. That level of commitment is shown in our 18 Ford President's Awards for overall customer experience. Whether you're looking for a tune-up, a trade-in, or a new F-150, the team at Davis Ford is here to serve you. Come see us today in Fulton, call us at 662-862-3711 or visit us online at davisfordsales.com. Davis Ford, small town dealership, small town prices.
Today tastes like a home game, like a huddle. Tastes like we're bringing the heat and like a front row seat. Today tastes like we're a team and it never tasted this good.
When I came back to school this year, I brought my bank with me, and the student checking account at First American National Bank was perfect for me. No monthly fees and no minimum balance, and I can manage my money right from the app. I can do all my banking with text messaging if I want, and I can deposit a check just by taking a photo. It's that easy at FAMB.
I took my bank to college with me.
I took my bank to college with me.
My bank followed me to college.
I took my bank to college with me.
I took my bank to college with me.
It's that easy at First American National Bank.
Good afternoon and roll tribe, ICC fans, as we're moments away from that First American National Bank opening pitch here in game one between ICC and East Mississippi. Let's take you to the field for today's Tupelo Coca-Cola starting lineups.
And now today's lineup for the visiting East Mississippi Lady Lions. Leading off from playing center field, number 17, Lauren Pickett. Batting second and playing third base, number 33, Jenna Kirkland. Batting third and playing catcher, number 3, Reagan Pritchett. Batting fourth and playing first base, number 22, Celeste Studi. Batting fifth and playing shortstop, number 16, Maggie Meadows. Batting sixth and the DP, number 25, Carly Martin. Batting seventh and playing second base, number 2, Abby Stevens. Batting eighth and playing left field, number 15, Malia Pogue. Batting ninth and playing right field, number 13, Aislinn Cochran. In the flex position as pitcher, number 8, Lakeland Firth. The head coach of the Lions is Whitney Hawkins. She is assisted by Mackenzie Bird and Johnny Hawkins. Today's lineup for your 22 ICC innings. Leading off and playing second, number 6, Hannah Henry. Batting second and playing center field, number 1, Mackenzie Patterson. Batting third and playing catcher, number 7, Kara Hayes. Batting fourth in the DP, number 19, Caroline Clark. Batting fifth and playing third base, number 18, Haley Alberson. Batting sixth and playing right field, number 30, Connor Stevens. Batting seventh and playing first base, number 17, Rain Rippey. Batting eighth and the pitcher, number 24, Madison Jenkins. Batting ninth and playing shortstop, number 5, Katie Boatner. The flex position as left field, number 10, Taylor Bishop. The head coach for ICC is Andy Kirk. He is assisted by Rick Lawson. Please rise and remove all headgear for the playing of the national anthem.
You're good.
Thank you.
Ever since we opened our doors in 1964, Davis Ford and Fulton has been committed to providing the highest level of customer service and customer satisfaction. That level of commitment is shown in our 18 Ford President's Awards for overall customer experience. Whether you're looking for a tune-up, a trade-in, or a new F-150, the team at Davis Ford is here to serve you. Come see us today in Fulton. Call us at 662-862-3711 or visit us online at davisfordsales.com. Davis Ford, small town dealership, small town prices.
Why didn't you answer your phone?
You're not gonna believe what just... You bought a Coca-Cola with zero sugar?
Yeah, why?
Come on, it has zero sugar.
Yep, and it's delicious.
I don't believe it.
Just try something new. You'll love it.
This does taste great.
First American offers online and mobile banking features to make your banking experience easy and safe. Activate or deactivate your debit card as needed, attach images to your transactions, apply travel notices to your account, and make person-to-person payments. You can even set up text alerts to guard against unauthorized spending or just to monitor your account balance. The best part, that you can bank anytime, anywhere. At First American National Bank, get that hometown feel, the high-tech touch.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as we're just moments away from that First American National Bank opening pitch here between ICC and East Mississippi. Game one of two this afternoon here in Fulton, as the First American National Bank opening pitch will go for a strike, and it comes your way at 159. So strike one, the call here to Lauren Pickett. It'll be Pickett, Kirkland, and Pritchard due up here. As there's going to be a grounder to the first baseman, we'll step on the bag and record out number one.
Now batting number 33, Jenna Kirkland.
So Pickett will go down on a routine ground ball to the first baseman, and now this will bring up Jenna Kirkland, who is the third baseman here in game one. In the circle for ICC is Madison Jenkins. We'll try to go over some of her Sonic stats here for you in a moment. As this pitch fouled back and out of play for strike one. Madison is 9-0 on the year with a save. She's pitched 63 and two-thirds inning, has given up 57 hits, 30 runs, 23 of those are earned. She struck out a team-high 62, has walked 15, and has a 2.53 ERA. Those are your Sonic stats on our starting pitcher, Madison Jenkins, here for ICC. ICC fans, don't forget, it's always happy hour. Thanks to the Sonic app, you can order half-price drinks or slushes anytime, thanks to the Sonic app. So with one out in the inning, Kirkland will dig in. 1-1 is the count. Fouls this one back, and we'll go to 1-2 now. Rafael Henry shooting highlights this afternoon. Lee Adams shooting photos. You can see those on ICCimages.com. He's also updating Twitter, so if you can't watch the game, need to come back and check on it every once in a while, you can do so there at Twitter. The 1-2 pitch set up on the outside. 2-2 now is the count. Baseball, they're at East Mississippi. They're moments away from their First American National Bank opening pitch. So awaiting the 2-2 pitch here from Jenkins. This one lifted. Going to be trouble, and it's going to drop for a base hit. Nice at bat there on the part of Kirkland.
Now batting number three.
To find a way to eventually win that. Just dropped it out in left center where nobody can get to it. And a one-out single now will bring up Reagan Pritchett. Pritchett, who is catching here in game two. We'll try to get East Mississippi off to a good start here. East Mississippi 4-23 on the year, 0-8 in conference play, but that is quite deceiving as they could put a lot of runs on the board. So it's one of those days that you can't judge the team on their record so far. So 0-1 is the count here. And This one lifted to the right side of the field. It's going to go back, and it's all to be off the wall. Stevens ran into the wall trying to track that one down, and it's going to go for a double. So Pritchett nearly gives one a ride there.
Celeste Studi.
And now with one out, this is going to bring up the first baseman, Celeste Studi, batting in that four spot. Studi will come in. And this is where East Mississippi wants to be. She's got a team best 439 and a team high 19 RBIs on 29 hits this season. Runners on second and third. East Mississippi trying to strike early here, and looks like ICC is going to give the intentional walk here to Studi. Not going to try any chances with the bat of Studi. She also leads East Mississippi with four home runs on the season. And so that will be an intentional walk, and it will load the bases here. So ICC's got multiple options coming up. You'll have the double play on anything routine to the left side or maybe up the middle of the field. You do have the force out at home on a bunt attempt, but either way it goes, it's going to bring up the shortstop, Maggie Meadows. Before we get to that, I want to give a shout out to Miss Dana Kirk and her kindergartners out there watching right now in support of the Indians, hoping to see ICC get out of this jam here early. One out, bases loaded here for East Mississippi. That pitch in there for a strike from Jenkins. Meadows, as we already talked about, the shortstop, batting 290 on the year. She does have 10 RBIs. Is that pitch missing high and outside? One home run, three doubles. She does have 18 hits and 62 at-bats. Those are some more of your Sonic stats here early on in this one. 1-1 pitch. That one finds the outside corner. 1-2 now goes the count. Well, when we go to our wide cameras, if you see a lot of buses in the background, we're also hosting the Regional High School Archery Tournament at the Davis Event Center this week. Is that pitch on the outside? 2-2 now is the count to Meadows. So 2 balls, 2 strikes, 1 out, bases loaded here in the top of the first inning for East Mississippi. But waiting the 2-2 offering here from Jenkins. This one fouled back and will stay at 2-2. Well, ICC coming off a split with East Central in their last outing, trying to get back to their winning ways here. They're 21-3 on the year, 7-3 in conference play. And there's strike three. Beautiful pitch there from Jenkins. Finds that inside corner and finds out number two. That's a big one, as that's her first Renaissance Bank strikeout of the day. Renaissance Bank, the bank that understands you. Find out why by visiting renaissancebank.com. Now this will bring up the number six batter and the DP, Carly Martin, to the plate. Bases are still loaded here for East Mississippi. There's 2 outs in the inning, and that pitch across for a strike. So 0-1 is the count here to Martin, and she falls behind the count 0-2. Martin coming into this series batting 262 on the year with 8 RBIs. Going to have to guard the dish here as East Mississippi trying to avoid leaving the bases loaded here. Swing and a miss for strike three. Big time play there by Jenkins to get back-to-back Renaissance Bank strikeouts to end the inning and get out of the threat with no damage done. No runs on 2 hits, no errors, and 3 left on base. We'll take a break and come back with the bottom half of the first inning. Scoreless here in Fulton, back with more right after this.
Ooh, fumble. Let's give her a Renaissance replay. Make the right call with Renasant and get cell phone protection with Renasant Rewards Extra Checking. Sign up today.
$5 for my own money?
That's a bad call. Let's give him a Renasant replay. Sign up for Renasant Rewards Extra Checking with ATM refunds today.
Everyone has a unique story to tell. Maybe your story has you performing your new song in front of a crowd, getting to play your favorite sport, or enjoying a horseback ride in the country. At Orthopedic Institute of North Mississippi, our group of skilled surgeons understand your need to continue your story. That is why we are the preferred choice for orthopedic care. Thank you for choosing us. Our story is you. Orthopedic Institute of North Mississippi.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as we head now to the bottom of the first inning. It'll be Lakin Firth who is in the circle here for East Mississippi. She is 4-12 on the year. She's gone 7 complete games, has pitched 73 innings, has given up 123 hits, 81 runs. So that's going to be a grounder to the left side. Nobody is at first base. And so now ICC is going to be able to run a while here. And so that will go for an infield single. And E3 because nobody was really covering the bag there.
Now batting number 1, Mackenzie Patterson.
As Henry was there without a doubt. And was able to advance to third on the error. And so a big time break there for the Indians. And now this is going to bring up the center fielder, Mackenzie Patterson. So ICC could have a chance here to strike early in the bottom of the first. That was Henry's 31st hit of the year. As this is Patterson at the plate, batting 435 on the season. Swings on this one, fouls it back. 1-1 now is the count. So Patterson with a runner at third. Mackenzie does have 18 RBIs on the year. Would love to find her 19th here. Awaiting the pitch here from Firth. Swung at a rise ball, misses. And that's going to be strike two. 1-2 now is the count here to Patterson. Game one between ICC and East Mississippi. Thank you for tuning in. Is that pitch going to miss outside for a ball? So 1-2 now is the count here to Patterson. This one fouled down the first baseline. It will stay foul and will stay at 1-2. So 1 ball, 2 strikes, no outs. Runner at third here for ICC. And there's strike three. Gave her the edge. And that was an extreme pitch on the outside there going the way of Firth. And so now with one out, this is going to bring up Kara Hayes to the plate. So one away, and Hayes will dig in. Hayes catching here in the first game of the day. This is that pitch inside for a ball. Kara is batting 440 on the season. She's got a 449 on-base percentage. 680 is her slugging percentage. That appears to be best on the team. She does have 24 RBIs, and that leads the team as well. This one ripped. Right fielder will be able to camp underneath it. They're going to test her arm. The throw is going to be up the line, and that's going to be a sacrifice fly. So Hayes gets the job done there, absolutely smashes one out to right field. That turns into a ICC BSU sack fly. She does get the RBI to extend on her team best 24, so now she has 25. And this will be the DP, Caroline Clark, coming to the plate. That sacrifice fly being brought to you by the ICC Baptist Student Union. As they remind you of the ultimate sacrifice paid for our sins, that's the ICC BSU. Follow them on Twitter give them a shout out on Twitter at ICCBSU and thank them for sponsoring today's contest. That pitch missing outside for a ball. And that one in there for a strike. 2-1 now is the count. 2 balls, 1 strike. And this one popped up here. Could be trouble, but the second baseman comes over and makes the play for out number 3. But the Indians do strike first, thanks to a sacrifice fly off the bat of Hayes that scores Henry, and ICC leads it 1-0. We'll take a break here. A few more words from our sponsors, including Little Caesars, and be back with more right after this on the ICC Sports Network.
One hot and ready classic. We actually changed it with...
What? You changed Little Caesars? You've changed! They've changed Balloon Bro!
You've changed Karate Man!
How can you dance during a time like this?
You've changed! Tell me why!
It tastes even better because we added 33% more pepperoni.
Give me one of those.
Walk in and walk out with the new Hot and Ready Classic with 33% more pepperoni.
Pizza, pizza.
Hey, Indian fans, I'm Ricky Murphy, real estate agent, Tommy Morgan Realtors, and I'm also a proud alumni of the All-American Marching Band. Itawamba Community College was my home for 2 years, and where you decide to make your home will be one of the most important decisions of your life. Whether you're looking to create a plan to buy your first home, or if you're ready today to make a move into your forever home, give me a call or send me a message so we can discuss your next move. And for my family,
Roll Tide!
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as we move to the second inning. That first inning was being brought to you by Sam's Town Market. Sam Ferris and the rest of the crew at Sam's Town Market proudly serve some of the best meat and produce around. They also have a wide variety of specialty items. Stop by and visit Sam's Town Market, located right there in the heart of Mantachie. Sam Ferris, a good friend to the ICC softball program. Appreciate him helping bring today's action your way. This is going to be Abby Stevens to the plate now, as she takes that first pitch low for a ball. Stevens, Pogue, and Cochran scheduled up here for East Mississippi. Stevens batting 274 on the season. Windy afternoon could cause some problems out in the outfield as bunt attempt caught a strike. 1-1 now is the count. The ball's traveled well, though, with the wind blowing into the ballpark for most of the part of the day. We saw one of the East Mississippi hits by Pritchett end up against the wall out there in right field. 1-1 pitch coming from Jenkins. This one lifted to the left side. It's going to get out of play. And now the count will go 1-2. Well, anything to the left side of the field, I cannot see. I've got a wall here to my left side, so I kind of have to judge the best I can on the screen and also by following the home plate umpire, if you will. So waiting the 1-2 pitch here from Jenkins. She's already got 2 Renaissance Bank strikeouts. Can she make it 3? Instead, this one's fouled back, and we'll do it all over again. ICC leads it 1-0 thanks to an ICC Baptist Student Union sack fly by Kara Hayes that scored Hannah Henry. So waiting the 1-2 pitch here. This one fouled back, and we'll do it again. ICC also took advantage of a throwing error there in the bottom of the first. Nobody covering first base after the third baseman threw it there. Allowed Henry to go from first to third on the error. That pitch outside missing, 2-2 now is the count. Some of the ICC fans not appreciating that call there, even though it was very clearly low and outside that time. 2-2. Grounder, left side, foul, and we'll stay at 2-2. East Mississippi in the reverse pinstripes. You normally see a white uniform with the black pinstripes, but they're going with the black uniforms and the white pinstripes. I like them. ICC, and they're all reds. as we wait for the 2-2 pitch here. And this one's fouled off. Nice at bat going right now here by Abby Stevens. We talked about it. She came into the series batting 274. She's got a 346 on base percentage. She does have 20 hits on the year. That's good for third on the team. She does have three doubles, which is also good for third on the team. 2-2 pitch from Jenkins. And this one popped up back and out of play again, and we'll keep going as Stevens doing a good job of battling off a lot of these pitches, having to relay some balls in here. So waiting the 2-2 pitch from Jenkins. Stevens trying to find a way to win the battle here. Swing and a miss for strike three. That is her third Renaissance Bank strikeout of the game. Third straight as well for Jenkins. And now Malia Pogue will come to the plate. Malia is batting in that eighth spot, playing in left field. Jenkins having to tie her shoe here. Let's take a look at some numbers on Pogue. She's batting 160. She's got a 222 on base percentage and 200 slugging percentage. Swings in the first pitch she sees, left side, and diving catch made. And robbing Pogue of a hit out there. As that's our left fielder, that's going to be Taylor Bishop getting the start out there in left field. And coming in and making a great play. And so now with two outs, this will be the number nine batter, Aislinn Cochran, coming to the plate. So two away and nobody on here for the Lions in the top of the second. That pitch just a bit too high. Ball one. So 1-0 is the count here to Cochran. She's playing in right field. That pitch, fastball in there for a strike. 1-1 now is the count to Cochran. Cochran's got 7 hits, 2 doubles, 1 RBI. She has struck out 18 times this season. Trying to avoid that here and see if she can spark a 2-out rally. Takes that pitch high for a ball. 2-1 now is the count. She has walked 4 times. Glancing over at baseball, and we'll give you a Renaissance Bank scoreboard update here in a moment with that one. Awaiting the 2-1 pitch here from Jenkins. Swung on and evens up the count now at 2-2. Indians off to a good start in baseball at East Mississippi as they finish the top of the fourth inning. Or actually, it could be in the first inning. ICC leads it 4-0. There's a hard hit ground ball. Second baseman Hannah Henry finds it, tosses it over without any issues. 4-3 for a 3-up, 3-down inning there in the second. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. We'll take you to a break, hear a few more words from our sponsors, and be back with more right after this on the ICC Sports Network.
This is you, right? Like, you're like, bacon, bacon, bacon.
Well, this is you.
I love bacon.
Sonic Bacon on Bacon Quarter Pound Double Cheeseburger.
Okay, you got me.
I need a double stuffed Oreo blast, guys.
You got it.
Gonna need a double stuffed Oreo waffle cone too.
Coming right up.
Order up. Sonic double stuffed Oreo waffle cone and blast.
Want to make a good living? Come learn a skill at Max Home. Upholstery trainees start at $15.50 an hour. Our upholsterers average $23 an hour and can make above $28 an hour on production. We're also offering a $500 sign-on bonus to experienced upholsterers. Max Home is hiring for all positions and is willing to train quality people. Max Home makes all their custom-built products in the USA. Join the best. Train with the best. Be the best. Max Home, Bolton, Mississippi, and Max Home, Sullivan, Alabama.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as we head now to the bottom of the second inning. It'll be Haley Alberson, Connor Stevens, and Rain Rippey 2-up for the Indians here in the second. And that first pitch in there for strike. Firth still in the circle here for East Mississippi. This second inning being brought to you by the Kegel Eye Center. They've been providing professional and comprehensive eye care to the people of Itawamba County and the surrounding areas. They're located at 402 Access Road right here in Fulton. To set up your appointment, give them a call at 662-862-EYES. That's 662-862-EYES. This one hammered and is caught up against the wall. Out there in left field, you heard some of the fans trying to encourage it out of the ballpark. But again, that wind, the way it's blowing today, if you hit it to the left side of the field, you're going to have to touch it pretty hard as the wind blowing basically across the field, left to right. And that one will go for a long, exciting out. Now up is going to be Connor Stevens. Stevens looks at that first pitch, called a strike, judging by the first inning and a half so far. This home plate umpire likes the pitches up today, and that could be dangerous for pitchers, as that's going to be in the power zone for a lot of these batters today, as this pitch fouled back and out of play. 0-2 now. We'll go the count here to Connor Stevens, who is playing in right field. Saw her have to chase one down that took her into the fence earlier. She did a great job of quickly bouncing back and relaying that one in to keep the run off the board for East Mississippi. 1-0 is the score, ICC with the lead. There's an example of a pitch that looked pretty good, but called low. 1-2 now is the count here to Stevens. So waiting the 1-2 pitch here to Stevens. Ripped left side. It's going to be thrown out in time. Great play over there by the third baseman just to make the snag pop up and throw it over. Again, I'm blocked from that view to be able to see exactly if it gets through or not. And now this will be Rain Rippey. So two great defensive plays by East Mississippi. Has two quick outs here. And now the first baseman, Rain Rippey, will come to the plate. Rain batting 333 on the year. Trying to spark the bats here with two outs. Swings on the first pitch she sees. Could be trouble, but slicing foul. About a foot and a half down the line, it goes foul. And so that'll go for strike one. 0-1 the count here to Rain Rippey. If she were to reach, then it'd be Madison Jenkins up next for the Indians. So Rippey rips this one, second baseman finds it, throws over, and it's going to be a 3-up, 3-down inning there for the Indians in the bottom of the second. We've played two in Fulton, 1-0 ICC with the lead. We're going to take a timeout here. More words from our sponsors. And be back with more right after this.
Age-related macular degeneration is the leading cause of severe vision loss in adults over the age of 50. Symptoms are gradual loss to see objects clearly. Objects appear distorted in shape. Darker, empty areas appear in the center of your vision. In a comprehensive eye exam, your optometrist will perform a variety of tests to determine if you have macular degeneration. For questions or concerns, call Kegel Eye Center in Fulton at 862-EYES. Providing professional, comprehensive eye care to the people of Itawamba County and the surrounding areas. KegelEyeCenter.com.
So when are you going to give me back for the pizza?
Oh, personal foul. Let's give him a Renaissance replay. Make a successful handoff when you transfer funds to friends and family with Zelle in the Renaissance mobile app. Let's give him a Renaissance replay. Make the right call for 24/7 roadside assistance and sign up for Renaissance Rewards Extra Checking today.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as we head to the third inning. This third inning being brought to you by Max Home. Max Home here in Fulton and Seligent, Alabama. They're hiring for all positions and are willing to train quality people. Join the best, train with the best, be the best. That's Max Home, again, here in Fulton and Seligent, Alabama. Back to the top of the lineup here for East Mississippi, and this is Pickett coming to the plate. She grounded out to the first baseman in her first attempt of the afternoon. Jenkins still in the circle here for the Indians. That pitch in there for a strike. So 0-1 the count here to Pickett, the center fielder. Wind continuing to pick up. Of course, again, this time of year, we know that weather's going to get crazy, and it's supposed to be some potential bad weather tomorrow. I know we're under a wind advisory from about 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. tomorrow, and I think the entire state is warned to be watchful for bad weather. Tornadic weather, of course, we hope none of that happens tomorrow, of course, as this pitch is fouled off. 1-2 now goes the count. So one ball, two strikes, and no outs. Pickett, Kirkland, and Pritchett scheduled up. So waiting the 1-2 offering here from Jenkins. Swung on and missed for strike three. Another Renaissance Bank strikeout there. That is her fourth of the game.
Jenna Kirkland.
And fourth of the last six batters. And now this would be Kirkland coming to the plate. In her previous appearance, she kind of just put one where they ain't, as they say, as she dropped one out there behind the shortstop and center fielder. Swings on this one, fouls it back, and that'd be strike one. Well, you can hear the wind blowing on our external mic. It's blowing directly into the press box now. For the most part, it's kind of shifting back and forth. It'll blow left to right across the field or either into the field. As Jenkins deals this one, it's popped up. Foul territory and a collision, but does she hang on to it? Yes, she does. As that was the catcher, Hayes, that came away with it. She was able to hang on the ball after colliding with Alberson there. Both players seem to be okay, so that will be out number two. So with two away now, this will bring up Reagan Pritchett to the plate. She doubled off the wall in right in her previous at-bat. So ICC trying to return serve with a three-up, three-down inning here in the top of the third. This one popped up and out of play, and that'll go for strike one. So 0-1 the count here to Pritchett. East Mississippi out hitting the Indians right now, 2-1, as we're here in the top of the third inning. Nice inside pitch there. Pritchett just couldn't hang off on it. 0-2 will now go the count. Well, the Indians are off to an impressive start. Up 7-0 in baseball at East Mississippi. Looks like they just hit a home run as this pitch popped up. It'll get out of play as well. If you're wanting to watch that one, and it's on the East Mississippi YouTube page, you can go to their website, emccathletics.com, and I think it's under multimedia is where you can keep an eye on that game. We do want to welcome those watching in favor of East Mississippi here, and also say hello to the members of the ICC family that's tuned in. Is that pitch missing outside? We've already said hello to Miss Dana's kindergartners, that famous group out there. Hopefully they're behaving today as they're quietly cheering on the Indians. Awaiting the 1-2 count pitch here from, and it goes up high, 2-2 now, is the count here to Pritchett. So two balls, two strikes, two outs, nobody on. Ripped and pulled foul. Well, this is the first of two games this afternoon. If you happen to be watching, maybe getting off work here in a few moments, you got enough time to come out for game two. We encourage you to do so. An absolute beautiful day for softball here, almost Chamber of Commerce-like day. as we await the 2-2 pitch here from Jenkins. And this one popped up. Shortstop will go back and make the play for out number two. So the Indians do return serve with a 3-up, 3-down top part of the third inning. For ICC, it'll be the 8-9-1 batters two up, Jenkins, Boatner, and Henry. But we're going to take a break and come back with more right after this.
Ever since we opened our doors in 1964, Davis Ford in Fulton has been committed to providing the highest level of customer service and customer satisfaction. That level of commitment is shown in our 18 Ford President's Awards for overall customer experience. Whether you're looking for a tune-up, a trade-in, or a new F-150, the team at Davis Ford is here to serve you. Come see us today in Fulton. Call us at 662-862-3711 or visit us online at davisfordsales.com. Davis Ford. Small town dealership, small town prices.
They say Diet Coke is a mom's drink. Well, you copied her jeans, her spin, her shoes, her scrunchie, and whether you realize it or not, her music. Now, copy her drink. Drink what your mama gave you.
Today tastes like staying in. And it never tasted this good.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as you see the throwdown there as we get set to start the bottom of the third inning. It'll be Madison Jenkins, Katie Boatner, and then back to the top of the lineup in Hannah Henry. Hannah has the only hit of the day for the Indians. There was two outstanding defensive plays in the bottom of the second that robbed ICC of a couple of hits. So the Indians trying to get the bats fired up here in the bottom of the third, leading 1-0. That pitch drifts high and outside for a ball. The only run of the game so far came in the bottom of the first. It was after Hannah Henry reached on a single. Throwing error allowed her to get all the way over to third, and then it was an ICC Baptist Student Union sacrifice fly by Kara Hayes that gives the Indians this 1-0 lead. Jenkins turns on this one, pulls it foul, and that'll go for a strike. So 1-1 is the count here on Jenkins. This one blistered, but slices foul. Well, that was right over the head of the first baseman. She did the best she could to jump up and try to quickly react to that one. It just had too much spin on it as it goes foul. And that'll go for strike two here against Jenkins. Jenkins batting .296 on the year. Trying to improve on those numbers right here with a 1-2 count. Jammed her a little bit. Second baseman's going to come up, going to have to hurry, and throws it over in time. So back-to-back putouts by the second baseman. And this will bring up Katie Boatner. Boatner batting in that number 9 spot. Boatner on the year batting .231 with a .333 on base percentage. .256 is her slugging percentage. She does have 9 hits on the season. Looking to enter double digits with a hit here. That pitch outside corner called a strike. So Boatner and then Hannah Henry is up next for the Indians. And that pitch caught a ball. Wow, that one looked like a carbon copy of the last one. So it's a mystery on that outside corner right now. 1-1 is the count with one out. Boatner rips it, but straight to the shortstop. Throw over in time, 6-3. So ICC playing some atom ball right now. As everything's right at them. And now we go back to the top lineup here in Hannah Henry. Henry with the only hit of the day for the Indians. And so she's going to try to see if she can spark something here with two outs. Bottom of the third, ICC leading this one 1-0. Swings on this one, fouls it right back into your living room for strike one. So 0-1 is the count here to Hannah Henry. Waits on that changeup, and it's going to be hit to the third baseman. Not going to be in time as the Speedy Henry gets down the line for her second hit of the game. And now this is going to bring up Mackenzie Patterson.
Now batting number one, Mackenzie Patterson.
So Patterson was a strikeout victim in her previous at-bat, the only strikeout of the day for ICC. Patterson came into this series batting .435. She had a .557 on base percentage and a .623 slugging percentage. That good on second on the team. So they're going to look Hannah Henry back to first. Hannah does have 19 stolen bases on the year. ICC has successfully stolen 85 out of 90 attempts. So that pitch finds the outside corner for a strike. 1-1 now is the count. So 1 ball, 1 strike, and 2 outs. Runner at first. And a little hit and run action going there. That one pulled foul, and now the count will go 1-2 here on Patterson. We won't have any other sports going until this weekend. And it'll be a big weekend both for ICC softball and baseball. Baseball will be hosting Colin. ICC softball will be traveling to Colin, who I believe moved up to number 2 in the country in this week's poll. Runner goes. Throw is not going to be in time as it actually hits the runner. And that kept it from going to the outfield. So a stolen base there for Henry. And now that is going to be her 20th stolen base of the season. Of course, the record for most stolen bases in a season held by former assistant coach at East Mississippi is... Now the count goes full at 3-2. Kimmy Nicholson, when she was here at ICC, she had 54 of 56 stolen bases her sophomore year. And that one's going to hit her. So a hit batter will send Patterson down to first. And now this will bring up Kara Hayes, who had a sacrifice fly to right in her previous at-bat. With 2 outs now, Kate Hayes will dig in and see if she can get her second, maybe even third RBI of the game.
Now batting number 7, Kara Hayes.
We talked about it earlier in the contest. Hayes came into the series batting .440. She leads the team with, or excuse me, she's actually second on the team with 25 RBIs. Alberson leads the team with 28. Or excuse me, no, she's actually third now that I look at the list because Caroline Clark has 27. So a chance to tie Clark here if she can drive in a couple of runs. That first pitch missing for a ball. 1-0 is the count. That pitch goes high. 2-0 now is the count. Firth is in the circle here. And now time is going to be taken. They're going to try to come in and kind of just get Firth to settle down a little bit. First time she's had a little bit of a hiccup here. As her defense has been money behind her today, other than that error to start the game. And that was, it was a throwing error because she threw the ball, but it was more of a mental error because nobody covered first base. And this one's going to be popped up high into the afternoon. Right fielder comes in, can't get to it. One run will score. And that will go down, or actually 2 runs will score now. And that's going to have to be a double. As that was tough, as that was an extremely long run there for the right fielder.
Now batting number 19, Caroline Clark.
As the right fielder, Aislinn Cochran, did everything she could to get to the ball there. And by the time she got to where the ball was, it was just... She ran into it, I guess. It did hit her in the arm, kind of the wrist area of the glove, but she was playing all the way back near the warning track and made a long sprint to get to it there. So she did the best she could to get to it. That's going to drop as a heads-up base running double there for Hayes as she ends up at second. Clark rips one, but a nice play over there at first base. Look what I found on that line drive to retire Clark. But the Indians do get two runs on two hits, no errors, and one left on base. We'll head to the top of the fourth, but before we do that, let's hear from the Orthopedic Institute of North Mississippi.
Ankle sprains are one of the most common sports injuries, with an estimated 25,000 occurring every day in the United States. Sprains can happen with any sport, including just walking across the yard. Ankle sprains are most common in ball sports such as basketball, soccer, volleyball, and others. As with any injury, your body quickly sends blood to start healing the process, which leads to the swelling. Rest, ice, compression, elevation, known as RICE, is a good way to treat an ankle sprain. This decreases the swelling, lessens your pain, and allows your body to heal the injury. Studies have shown that the sooner you return to activity, the better and typically the faster you will recover. Depending on the amount of injury to the ligaments, it may be days, weeks, or even months to return to high-intensity sports. Sometimes recovery may be slow, but if it gets better day by day or week by week, you are on the right path. If the ankle seems to stop improving and you just can't get back to your activities, then it's time to come see us at the Orthopedic Institute of North Mississippi. Remember, our story is you.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as we move now to the top of the fourth inning. As it will be the 4-5-6 batters, Studi, Meadows, and Martin scheduled up here.
Now batting number 22, Celeste Studi.
It's in the third inning in baseball, and ICC's up 8-0. So Studi will start us off. She was intentionally walked back in the first inning to load the bases, and it worked well for the Indians as they pitched around her, then got back-to-back Renaissance Bank strikeouts to get out of the inning with no damage done. That pitch from Jenkins to Studi, in there for a strike. So 0-1 is the count. And that one just missing for a ball. 1-1 now goes the count. So one ball, one strike, no outs. As Studi, the first baseman, starting us off here in the top of the fourth. Hard hit ground ball, and it's going to be a foul. And so now the count will go 1-2. Good crowd still making the way out to the ballpark. It's what they're calling a field day today here at ICC, as students and faculty and staff are participating in some field events over in the band practice field. So that's keeping our numbers down a little bit with some of the students participating in that. 1-2 now is the count here to Studi. And there's strike three. Beautiful pitch right there on that inside corner for the first out, and that is the fifth Renaissance Bank strikeout of the game for Jenkins. And now this will bring up the shortstop, Maggie Meadows, who struck out looking in her only at bat of the game. Swings on the first one, gets over the head of the first baseman, and that will go for a base hit. Nice strong hit there off the bat of Meadows, and that will be the third hit of the game for East Mississippi.
Carly Martin.
And now this will bring up the DP, Carly Martin. She struck out swinging to end the first. So she'll want to redeem herself here, and with a runner on first, see if East Mississippi can get something going here in the top of the fourth, as they trail it 3-0 here in game one. This one popped up. It's going to get out of play and go for strike one. This fourth inning being brought to you by the Bank of Oklahoma. John Herod and all the fine folks out there at the Bank of Oklahoma are proud to help bring today's action your way here on the ICC Sports Network. They're located at 227 West Main Street. You can visit them at bankofoklahoma.com as that pitch inside for a ball. Appreciate John. They've been a longtime sponsor of ICC Athletics. One and one now is the count. One out and a runner at first. Thought about going at that one, call it a ball. Two and one now is the count. So two balls, one strike, and one out. Runner at first. That's your situation here in the top of the fourth with ICC leading 2-1. Runner goes. Throw down is not in time, as that'll be a stolen base for Meadows. Meadows just got underneath that tag there, so stolen base will move the runner into scoring position. And now the count goes 3-1 here to Martin. First time that we've seen Jenkins kind of fall in a 3-1 hole here in game one. This one popped up, and it's going to get out of play, and now the count will go full at 3-2. Three balls, two strikes, one out, runner at second. East Mississippi trailing this one 3-0 here. We're in the top of the fourth inning. And, oh, going to call that one ball four, just a little bit too low and inside for the umpire's liking. First walk of the afternoon here for Jenkins. Actually, first walk of the day for either team.
Now batting number two, Abby Stevens.
And now this will be Abby Stevens coming to the plate. Shows bunt, pops it up. It goes back over the top of us here in the ICC Alumni Association and Foundation broadcast booth. If you'd like to find out how you can contribute to Itawamba Community College through the Indian Club and give to the ICC softball team, visit iccms.edu/Indian Club. That's iccms.edu/Indian Club. Shows bunt again, lays it down. Only one play, and it's going to be the first. Now it's going to be an error. One run's going to score. They're going to ask two to score. And they will. So East Mississippi makes it a one-run contest on the throwing error on the sacrifice bunt attempt.
Now batting number 15, Malia Pope.
And that's what East Mississippi was looking for. And not only did they score the two runs, but the tying run advanced to second in that situation. So now this will bring up Malia Pogue, as Coach Kurt wants to come out and kind of settle the team down here in this situation. Checking in on baseball again. That's on emccathletics.com. ICC leading that one 8-0 in the third inning. Don't imagine we'll see a pitching change here, although they do have Emily Robinson getting loose in the bullpen for the Indians. Just a mental mistake there by ICC. We saw that in the first inning by East Mississippi. The Indians were able to cash in on that one for a run. Now East Mississippi was able to cash in with two runs to make it a 3-2 lead here in favor of the Indians. Home plate umpire slowly making his way out to the circle. Going to try to speed things up here as Coach Kurt wraps up his conversation. And so a big answer there in the top of the fourth after ICC puts two runs in the bottom of the third. East Mississippi comes back with two more here. In the top of the fourth, there is a runner at second with one out. And this is Malia Pogue, the left fielder, at the plate. So Pogue will dig in the situation, trying to see if she can push across the tying run. Swings on this one, fouls it off to the left side, and that'll go for strike one. So 0-1 is the count here to Pogue. She flew out to left in her only at bat of the contest. Swings on this one, lifts it to center field. Patterson will come in, makes the play, and will look the runner back to second. And so now with two outs in the inning and runner at second, Aislinn Cochran will come to the plate.
Now batting number 13, Aislinn Cochran.
So ICC trying to get out of this inning with minimum damage done, two outs. Runner at second, number nine batter, right fielder Aislinn Cochran now coming to the plate. She grounded out to the second baseman to end the second. Takes that first pitch outside for a ball. Or excuse me, actually called that one a strike. That one looked to be a little bit high and outside, but came back and said it got enough of the zone there. 0-1 is the count. And that one in there. Quickly heading the count now is Jenkins at 0-2 here on Cochran. So 0-2 now is the count as the wind picking up big time, blowing basically from foul pole to foul pole. Grounder, pitcher finds it, throws over in time for the out. 1-3 for those of you scoring at home, as that will end the fourth inning. But they do strike back with two runs on one hit and one error. 3-2, ICC with the lead over East Mississippi as we move to the bottom of the fourth here in game one in Fulton. Back with more right after this on the ICC Sports Network.
When I came back to school this year, I brought my bank with me, and the student checking account at First American National Bank was perfect for me. No monthly fees and no minimum balance, and I can manage my money right from the app. I can do all my banking with text messaging if I want, and I can deposit a check just by taking a photo. It's that easy at FAMB.
I took my bank to college with me.
I took my bank to college with me.
My bank followed me to college.
I took my bank to college with me.
I took my bank to college with me.
It's that easy at First American National Bank.
Bringing home the Batman calzone from Little Caesars might make you feel like Batman. But could you really be the Batman?
A little help here!
Never mind. But at least the new Batman calzone with a calzone crust will make you feel like you're a superhero. The Batman, in theaters March 4th.
Pizza, pizza.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. As Haley Auberson will start us off here in the bottom of the fourth. She gave one a ride in her previous at bat, and it was a catch up against the wall. Couldn't tell if she robbed the home run or not. As I believe it was just one that put the left fielder up against the fence to make the catch, as that first pitch going high for a ball. So Alberson, who was named MACC Pitcher of the Week, and then Player of the Week, National Player of the Week as well. And the ball went right back to the pitcher. We're going to take a timeout and be back with more right after this.
Everyone has a unique story to tell. Maybe your story has you performing your new song in front of a crowd, getting to play your favorite sport, or enjoying a horseback ride in the country. At Orthopedic Institute of North Mississippi, our group of skilled surgeons understand your need to continue your story. That is why we are the preferred choice for orthopedic care. Thank you for choosing us. Our story is you. Orthopedic Institute of North Mississippi.
If this just cost a little bit less.
Let's take a look at that with a Renaissance replay. Make the right call with over 400,000 shopping discounts right from the Renaissance Rewards Extra Checking app.
Might be a little while before I get to the bank.
That's an incomplete pass. Let's give it a Renaissance replay. Renaissance Mobile Check Deposit. Make the right call and open an account with Renaissance today.
This is you, right? Like, you're like, bacon, bacon, bacon.
Well, this is you.
I love bacon.
Sonic Bacon on Bacon Quarter Pound Double Cheeseburger.
Okay, you got me.
I need a double stuffed Oreo blast, guys.
You got it.
Gonna need a double stuffed Oreo waffle cone, too.
Coming right up.
Order up. Sonic double stuffed Oreo waffle cone and blast.
Hey, Indian fans. I'm Ricky Murphy, real estate agent, Tommy Morgan Realtors, and I'm also a proud alumni of the All-American Marching Band. Itawamba Community College was my home for 2 years, and where you decide to make your home will be one of the most important decisions of your life. Whether you're looking to create a plan to buy your first home, or if you're ready today to make a move into your forever home, give me a call or send me a message so we can discuss your next move. And from my family,
Roll Tribe!
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We have a call to the bullpen here, being brought to you by Tommy Morgan, real estate agent Ricky Murphy, and he reminds ICC fans as well as East Mississippi fans, when you're ready to make the call either to sell your current home or maybe buy your next dream home, to give him a call at 662-321-9824. That's 662-321-9824. That's Ricky Murphy, Tommy Morgan, real estate agent. New pitcher in the game is going to be Maggie Meadows. She was playing shortstop. She comes in with 44 innings of work, has given up 55 runs on 82 hits, 42 of those earned. She has struck out 16, has walked 12. The new shortstop is going to be Lauren Pickett, who is out in center field and can't necessarily see the number of the new center fielder for East Mississippi. We'll see how they kind of continue to move things around here. Hopefully, Lakin Firth is okay after that line drive. It was blistered. Came right back to her. The trainers here at ICC checking her out to make sure she's okay. So we do have a new center fielder out there. Unfortunately for you guys, the numbers extremely small in the front of the jerseys here for East Mississippi, so we're unable to bring you that name there. This is now going to be Connor Stevens, who is going to greet Meadows to the contest. Runner at first, that is Alberson. At first pitch, going to go high for a ball. Also, to finish out those Sonic stats, Olmedo, she is 0 for 5 on the year with a 6.68 ERA. So 1-0 is the count here to Connor Stevens. Shows bunt, lays it down right back to the pitcher. Throw over is in time, and that will be an ICC BSU sacrifice bunt by Stevens that allows the runner to advance to second. And now this will be Rain Rippey coming to the plate.
Now, number 17, Rain Rippey.
So Rippey will come in playing first base today here in game one. She entered this series batting .333. She's got 6 RBIs on the year. Would love to see if she can find number 7 right now. Rippey grounded out to second in her only at bat so far here in game one. 3-2 is your score. We're in the bottom of the fourth inning. Meadows taking over for an injured Firth in the circle here for East Mississippi. This one ripped hard left side. Third baseman finds it, throws it over. Now they're going to try to turn two, but they cannot. So the runner will advance to third. Hard hit ground ball. Nice play over there at third base by Kirkland to get that one over and get out number 2. And now this is going to bring up the pitcher, Madison Jenkins, to the plate. Jenkins can really help her own cause here with the base hit. She grounded out to second in her only appearance of the game so far. And so ICC with the runner at third, trying to see if they can pick up one of those 2 runs. Is that pitch inside corner for a strike? As we said, it's been a bit of a guessing game when the ball is on that left side of the plate. That one called a strike there. 0-1 now is the count here to Jenkins. Jenkins looks at that pitch, low and outside for a ball. Evens things up now at 1-1. So 1-1, 2 outs. Runner at third here for ICC. Jenkins swings and misses at that one. Good job by the catcher. Pritchett to locate that one directly underneath her in a hurry. Because if that one gets away, then ICC probably tries to score the run. And now the count goes 1-2 here on Jenkins. Meadows pitch up high. 2-2 now is the count to Jenkins. If Jenkins were to reach, it would be Katie Boatner up next for the Indians. And looks at that one in the dirt. 3-2 now is the count here on Jenkins. So Meadows going to have to bring her best here. See if she can get out of this inning with no damage done. Runner at third for the Indians. 3-2 count here to Jenkins. Jenkins blasts this one to the right side. Right fielder's going over and makes the catch. Outstretched. Thought it had gotten over her head for a second, but was able to find it and collect it for out number three. So the Indians leave a runner stranded at third. And we've played four in Fulton. ICC leads it 3-2. We'll take a break and be back with more right after this here on the ICC Sports Network.
Cost a little bit less.
Let's take a look at that with a Renaissance replay. Make the right call with over 400,000 shopping discounts right from the Renaissance Rewards Extra Checking app.
Might be a little while before I get to the bank.
That's an incomplete pass. Let's give it a Renaissance replay. Renaissance Mobile Check Deposit. Make the right call and open an account with Renaissance today.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as Jenkins stays in the circle here for ICC. Indians lead it 3-2 here as we move to the top of the fifth inning in game one. Go look over at baseball, and ICC leading East Mississippi 10-0. That's in the third inning there in Scuba. So the Indians trying to come out and pick up a big win there. I believe East Mississippi ranked in the top part of the conference there in baseball. And I tell you, man, what a wild year it has been. When it comes to baseball, ICC, not ranked, but has wins over the number 5 and number 7 team in the country. They're at 500 on the season in baseball. Shows bunt, went for it, and that one will go as a strike. So this is Pickett, who is now playing shortstop, started the game in center field. She is 0-2 on the day with a strikeout. As that pitch missing for a ball, 1-1 now is the count. East Mississippi scores a run, so it's now 10-1. That's in the third inning. Shows bunt, it goes foul, and now the count will go 1-2 here to Pickett. So Firth was the flex, so I don't know that we have to change the lineup in this situation. And they're going to appeal. She went. Yes, she did. And that's strike three. Just couldn't quite find the brakes on it that time. It is going to be the sixth Renaissance Bank strikeout of the day for Jenkins. Renaissance Bank, visit rewardsextra.com to learn more about Renaissance Bank's Rewards Extra checking account. They offer things like roadside assistance, cell phone insurance, over 400,000 discounts, along with all the great rates that Renaissance has to offer for you there. That one popped up high and reeled in there in foul territory by the third baseman. Second time that Kirkland has fouled out to the left side of the field. And so quickly, two away, and this will be Pritchett coming to the plate. She is 1-2 on the day with a double. She popped up to end the third to the shortstop in her most recent at-bat. Doubled off the wall in right field in her first at-bat of the day. Stands in, takes that one for strike one. Wind picking up now, again, basically blowing foul pole to foul pole. Don't really understand why they call them foul poles, because if it was to hit the pole, the ball would be fair. This one popped up. Wynn making it dance around second baseman. Will go back and squeeze it for the out. Indians get a three up, three down inning there in the top of the fifth. Do up for the Indians, Boatner, Henry, and Patterson. We'll see them after this break here on the ICC Sports Network.
Hey, Indian fans, I'm Ricky Murphy, real estate agent, Tommy Morgan Realtors, and I'm also a proud alumni of the All-American Marching Band. Itawamba Community College was my home for 2 years, and where you decide to make your home will be one of the most important decisions of your life. Whether you're looking to create a plan to buy your first home, or if you're ready today to make a move into your forever home, give me a call or send me a message so we can discuss your next move. And for my family,
Roll Trap!
In Searcy, Arkansas, a young man says, "I love you" for the first time, but his girlfriend doesn't quite hear. In Franklin, Tennessee, a boy encounters his first pickle. And in Kyle, Texas, after a mission for tots, cousins realize they're a long way from Kyle, Texas. One day, many people, millions of orders. This is Howie Sonic.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as we move now to the bottom of the fifth inning, as it'll be Katie Boatner, Hannah Henry, and Mackenzie Patterson scheduled up here for ICC. Still in the circle here for East Mississippi is Meadows, who was originally the shortstop after the ball was lined back to Firth, and hopefully she is okay. She was removed from the game, and Meadows took over for her there. Pickett took over at shortstop, and still a mystery on who is out there in center field right now for East Mississippi. As can't really see that number that far out. As Katie Boatner will dig in here. Katie, in her last appearance, grounded out to the shortstop. Show bunt, pulled it back for a ball. So 1-0 is the count here to Boatner. 3-2 is the score, bottom of the fifth. We'll give you a Sonic scoring recap after this pitch. It was one run as that pitch called a strike. One run in the bottom of the first for ICC. Then they went up 3-0 with a pair of runs in the bottom of the third. East Mississippi cashed in on an error by the Indians and pushed across two in the fourth. And that's where we're at right now with a 3-2 score. Swing and a miss there by Boatner. 1-2 now is the count here to the shortstop. So waiting the 1-2 offering here from Meadows. That pitch drifts high and outside. Not a bad spot to miss. See if you couldn't get her to chase a high one that time. Now the count evens up at 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, no outs, as Boatner starting us off here in the bottom of the fifth. And that one drifts outside, kind of got away a little bit from Meadows. I just see her, when she pitched it that time, kind of shifted hard to her right. And that's where the ball drifted to that time, as now the count goes full here to Boatner. And Katie looks at that one high for ball four. Nice job by Boatner to come back and find a way to win that battle and draw a leadoff walk here to start the inning. We're in the bottom of the fifth, ICC, with a 3-2 lead here. And now this is going to be Hannah Henry. Hannah is 2-for-2 on the day with a stolen base, two runs scored. So she is putting her name in the hat here for our Samstown Market star of the game at the end of the conclusion of this one, as that pitch goes high for a ball. Boatner over at first base. She has 8 stolen bases on the year. So 1-0 is the count. Henry shows bunt, lays it down, right back to the pitcher. And that's going to be an error. Well, that one just took a bad hop there. Came off the leg of the pitcher. E1 on the play. Second error of the game there for East Mississippi. And now ICC with runners at first and second and a lot of speed on the bases right now. And this will bring up Mackenzie Patterson to the plate. Patterson 0 for 1 on the day. She was hit by a pitch in her most recent at-bat. She did come around to score. She's also struck out on the afternoon as well. So East Mississippi trying to get in everybody on the same page here defensively. As that ball, as we said, just took a bad hop on Meadows. It just kind of took a higher hop than she was anticipating. Came off her leg, and ICC was able to get Henry on a sacrifice bunt attempt. Actually, I won't say that. She was trying to hit for a bunt. I don't call that a foul ball. I was looking down correcting my book that time. But yeah, she was, I won't call that a sacrifice bunt on that last attempt. So that foul ball will go for strike one. 0-1 the count here. We talked about in Patterson's last at bat, she was hit by a pitch on what would have been ball four. Shows bunt, pulls it back. Ball gets away and the runners will advance on the pass ball. Well, a big time opportunity here for McKenzie to see if she can pick up a couple of RBIs. She does have 18 of those on the year. Swing and miss for strike two. 1-2 is the count here to Patterson. Runners at second and third. There's no outs in the inning. Patterson looks at that one in the dirt. Ball blocked up nicely there. Again, Pritchett has played well behind the plate. Didn't necessarily know where that one went, but did keep it right there with her so the runners could not have a chance to score. Count goes 2-2, no outs. A lot of speed on the bases here for the Indians. Something down to the outfield could score two. That pitch missing outside now, 3-2 is the count here to Patterson. Wind blowing in basically from the scoreboard to the first base dugout. See the jerseys out there kind of whipping around in the wind. That's how much it's blowing today. 3-2 pitch, fouled off and we'll do it again. So the count will stay 3-2 here on Patterson. So waiting the 3-2 pitch once again here. Patterson will dig in. Runners at second and third. ICC leading this one 3-2 here in the bottom of the fifth. And that will be ball four. And ICC now will have bases
now
loaded.
Now batting for the Lady Indians, the catcher, number 7, Kara Hayes.
And this will bring up Kara Hayes to the plate. Lee Adams put it as an error on Twitter. I have to disagree. I called it a double on her last hit that drove in a couple of runs. She's got 3 RBIs on the day. Came in on the afternoon with 24 RBIs. Now she's one more away for taking a team lead in RBIs at 28. She can drive in 2, can take over the lead as a whole for RBIs on the season. So bases full of Indians here. Hayes pops this one up, it's gonna drop. It's gonna be a tough play. Is she there in time? And they're gonna say she is.
Now batting for the Lady
Way to hustle down the line there.
Left fielder.
Infield bloop single, if you will. And that will be another RBI, the 4th RBI of the day for Kara Hayes. And now this will be Clark coming to the plate. Bases still loaded here for ICC. They now lead it 4-2. Clark looks at that pitch right down the middle for a strike. Good job by Meadows not to let that last hit that kind of just dropped in no man's land to get in her head. Was able to come back and deliver a strike to get ahead of Clark here. 0-1 is the count. That pitch drifts high. Wind blowing directly into the infield now. or I should say into us here in the press box, as it's been whipping all around today. Mainly been going left to right for most of the afternoon. This one, Listert, it's going to be down. One run will score. Two runs will score for the Indians. And ICC now opening up a little bit, as that will go for a single.
Now advance on the throw.
Two RBIs for Caroline Clark. So ICC now takes a 6-2 lead, and now this will be Haley Alberson, who singled off the pitcher in her last at bat. Sees this one, and she's going to lift it to the left side. Left fielder will go over and makes the diving catch. Runner will tag from third, and that will go as an ICC BSU sack fly.
Right fielder, number 30.
That gets the run in. And so now the runner unable to advance from second. There's one out in the inning, a productive out, and ICC leads it now 7-2. Connor Stevens at the plate, as ICC has batted around plus one so far. Stevens in this inning had a sacrifice bunt. Oh no, excuse me, that is not the case, as that's going to be an error.
In the seventh slot, the first baseman, number 17.
That is going to be the second error of the inning. It was actually Boatner that started this inning off, so ICC has not batted around yet. Just two more batters and they will have. One out in the inning. And this is Rain Rippey coming to the plate. Well, ICC has scored four. And we're going to have a meeting in the circle. Let's take a quick break and hear a few words from our sponsors and be back with more right after this.
Hey, Indian fans, I'm Ricky Murphy, real estate agent, Tommy Morgan Realtors, and I'm also a proud alumni of the All-American Marching Band. Itawamba Community College was my home for 2 years, and where you decide to make your home will be one of the most important decisions of your life. Whether you're looking to create a plan to buy your first home, or if you're ready today to make a move into your forever home, give me a call or send me a message so we can discuss your next move. And from my family,
Roll Trav!
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Don't look like we'll have a change in the circle here, although it will give us time to identify our center fielder for East Mississippi, as it will be number 15, Pogue. So what that means is I now have to identify the left fielder, because Pogue was playing in left field. This one off to the right side will get out of play. Four strike one. Four runs here in the bottom of the fifth, and we got to credit those to Brother Chris, who showed up to the press box here, and ICC's bats woke up. Still one out in the inning. This one popped up to the right side. Right fielder will drift over and make the play. Runner will advance from second to third. So now ICC now will have runners on the corners with two outs.
From Cleveland, Madison Jenkins.
So now Madison Jenkins, who flew out to right to end the fourth, will dig in here to see if she can keep things going with two outs here in the bottom of the fifth. This is the ninth batter of the inning coming to the plate here for the Indians. So two away, runners on the corners here for ICC. We'll see if they try to do anything with the runner at first. And Stevens just basically going to jog to second. Now the run's going to come home. The run will score. So count the run, and Jenkins will be tagged out over at second.
5 runs, 3 hits, 1 runner left on base.
And so we'll take a break as ICC leads it 8-2. Back with more right after this here on the ICC Sports Network.
East
Want to make a good living? Come learn a skill at Max Home. Upholstery trainees start at $15.50 an hour. Our upholsterers average $23 an hour and can make above $28 an hour on production. We're also offering a $500 sign-on bonus to experienced upholsterers. Max Home is hiring for all positions and is willing to train quality people. Max Home makes all their custom-built products in the USA. Join the best. Train with the best. Be the best. Max Home, Bolton, Mississippi, and Max Home, Sullivan, Alabama.
Age-related macular degeneration is the leading cause of severe vision loss in adults over the age of 50. Symptoms are gradual loss to see objects clearly. Objects appear distorted in shape. Darker empty areas appear in the center of your vision. In a comprehensive eye exam, your optometrist will perform a variety of tests to determine if you have macular degeneration. For questions or concerns, call Kegel Eye Center in Fulton at 862-EYES. Providing professional, comprehensive eye care to the people of Itawamba County and the surrounding areas. Kegel Eye Center.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We do have a pitching change here to the Indians. So this call to the bullpen being brought to you by Tommy Morgan, real estate agent Ricky Murphy. He reminds all ICC fans and East Mississippi fans, as a matter of fact, when you're ready to make the call to either sell your current home or move to your next dream home, give Tommy Morgan, real estate agent Ricky Murphy, a call at 662-321-9824. That's 662-321-9824. We'll give you our new pitcher in the game after this pitch, as there's a swing and a miss for strike one. This is Allison Harrison that's coming in to pitch here. This is going to be her sixth appearance of the year. She does have a 1-0 record, has pitched 11 innings, as this one is going to be grounded to the left side, and I'm going to call a foul ball. 0-2 now is the count. Kind of delay on the foul call there. But to go back and look at some Sonic stats here once again on Allison Harrison. 1-0 in the year, has pitched 11 innings, given up 12 hits, 4 runs, all 4 of those earned. She has struck out 14 and has walked 4. She has a 2.55 ERA. An additional move defensively for the Indians is Jenkins will stay in the game. She will go from pitcher to first base. And then out in left field, Taylor Bishop started there, so she's still out there in left field. That's where I was looking to see if we might have had a change there as this pitch fouled off. 1-2 now is the count. So 8-2, ICC with the lead after 5 runs there in the bottom of the 5th inning. Game 1 between ICC and East Mississippi. Harrison in the circle with a 1-2 count. And there's strike 3.
Now batting, the shortstop.
Beautiful pitch there on that inside corner as equipment kind of just hiccup on me there. That's the first Renaissance Bank strikeout of the game for Harrison. One away now. That pitch missing low in the dirt. Look at a Renaissance Bank scoreboard update in baseball. ICC leading 11-3 in the fourth at East Mississippi. So the Indians off to a hot start out there in Scuba as that pitch drifts high for a ball. Speaking of baseball, I believe they're getting the new scoreboard put in today, or it's being worked on this week. As this one's going to be fouled off. And now the count will go 2-1 here to, I believe this is Meadows at the plate. Yes, Maggie Meadows. She is 1-for-2 on the day. She had a single, stole the base, and scored a run in her last appearance. So now 3-1 will go the count after that pitch misses low and inside. And that one finds the inside corner. 3-2 now goes the count here on Meadows. So Meadows going to have to guard the dish here. Harrison said if she can find her second straight Renaissance Bank strikeout. And that one, though, just missing inside, and The ICC faithful.
Now batting for East. The
thought
DP.
She had got that, but Number I believe it's a good call there, as Martin. It was just a little bit too inside for the liking of the home plate umpire. And now this will be Martin coming to the plate. One out and a runner at first. Martin on the afternoon, 0 for 1 with a walk and a strikeout. Fouls this one back and out of play for strike one. So 0-1 is the count. Martin walked and scored a run in her previous at bat. And that one called a strike. As we said, he likes that high pitch. That high and outside pitch has been consistently called a strike today for both teams. And at the end of the day, that's all you can ask is for that consistency for both pitchers. Runner goes, swing and a miss. Throw down is not in time. But that will be the second Renaissance Bank strikeout of the day.
Is the second baseman, number 2, Stevens.
And now this will be Stevens coming to the plate. She is 0 for 1 of the day. She did have a sacrifice bunt brought to you by the ICC Baptist Student Union in her previous at-bat. As this is going to be Abby Stevens, yes, coming to the plate. And not sure what the home plate umpire was going over to the ICC dugout to discuss with Coach Kirk. But either way it goes, there's two outs. Runner at second after Meadows picks up her second stolen base of the day. That pitch missing low and outside for ball one here to Stevens, who is playing second base. That one finds the corner for a strike. 1-1 now is the count. So one ball, one strike, two outs. Runner at second here for East Mississippi. Changeup floats up there, paints that outside corner for a strike. 1-2 now is the count. Well, this is a pitcher's strike zone today. That one just a bit outside. Goes for a ball. 2-2 now is the count. So two balls, two strikes, two outs, and a runner at second. And that one missing low. 3-2 now will go the count. As we said, he lights the pitches up, not so much down in the strike zone, but consistent he's been today, and that's all you can ask. That one just a little bit too high, and then we'll go for a walk. Second walk.
The slot is the left fielder, number 15. Pogue.
So now Pogue will be coming to the plate. Started the game playing at left field, has moved to center field during that multiple exchange whenever Firth was injured on a line drive hit back to her in the circle. That pitch finds the zone for a strike. We'll try to hopefully find out something about her and a good report for you in game 2. Indians up in this one, 8-2. That pitch in there for a strike, and nice job to quickly getting ahead in the count now, 0-2 here on Pogue. So runners on first and second. That pitch outside, not a bad spot to miss. See if you couldn't get her to chase one there. 1-2 now is the count here to Pogue. Swinging and a miss for strike three. Another Renaissance Bank strikeout.
No runs,
third of the inning.
No hits, no errors,
as
two runners left on
they
base.
Leave two runners on the bag, and ICC gets out of that inning with no damage done there in the top of the sixth. We come back, it'll be Jenkins, Boatner, and Henry scheduled up for the Indians. Back with more right after this on the ICC Sports Network.
Everyone has a unique story to tell. Maybe your story has you performing your new song in front of a crowd, getting to play your favorite sport, or enjoying a horseback ride in the country. At Orthopedic Institute of North Mississippi, our group of skilled surgeons understand your need to continue your story. That is why we are the preferred choice for orthopedic care. Thank you for choosing us. Our story is you. Orthopedic Institute of North Mississippi.
Ever since we opened our doors in 1964, Davis Ford in Fulton has been committed to providing the highest level of customer service and customer satisfaction. That level of commitment is shown in our 18 Ford President's Awards for overall customer experience. Whether you're looking for a tune-up, a trade-in, or a new F-150, the team at Davis Ford is here to serve you. Come see us today in Fulton. Call us at 662-862-3711 or visit us online at davisfordsales.com. Davis Ford, small town dealership, small town prices.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. New batter in the game here for ICC is going to be number 8, Sarah Kate Thompson. Coming into bat, she'll be batting for Madison Jenkins in this situation. Take a look at some stats on Sarah Kate. This is her 9th at bat of the year. She's got 2 hits, batting 125. She does have 2 RBIs on those 2 hits, or excuse me, no, 1 hit. And 2 RBI, so a productive hit she's had. She's stolen 2 bases. And she's also scored a couple of runs in a courtesy runner situation. This one hit foul to the left side. So, Skate, as they call her, take the SK from Sarah Kate and then add her number 8 to her name, if you will. Rips that one. Shortstop finds it. Throw over is just in time. Bang, bang, play not going the way of Thompson there. And a great play over there at shortstop by Pickett, who started the game out in center field to get that one and quickly, or zip it across quickly, I should say, and retire Thompson. Now this will be Katie Boatner coming to the plate. She's 0-for-1 of the day. Did walk, advanced on a pass ball, and scored a run. That pitch finds the outside corner for Meadows for strike 1. Hannah Henry on deck for the Indians. That one drifts outside for a ball. 1-1 now is the count. Wynn blowing out of the ballpark right now, actually. One of the few times it has. Going out to right field. And Boatner goes with the pitch, drops it out there in right field for the hit.
To the top of the order.
First hit of the day there for Boatner.
Number 6, Hannah Henry.
That is the 7th hit of the day for the Indians here. And now this is going to be Hannah Henry, who has 2 of those hits coming to the plate. She also reached on an error in the previous at-bat. She scored 3 runs as well. So with the runner at first, Henry will dig in. Runner's going to go, and the throw is going to be out to the outfield, and center fielder backing that one up nicely there as a stolen base for Boatner. And so, 1 out. And that one up a little bit too much. Caught a ball. So, 1-1 the count here to Henry. Swings and misses on that one. 1-2 now is the count here to the second baseman. 1 out in the inning, a runner at second here for the Indians. Meadows still in the circle. That one drifts high and outside, evens up the count now at 2-2. Remind you, our next broadcast will be coming your way right back here on the Red Channel on Saturday as ICC gets set to take on Colin in baseball. 2-2 pitch. Slap to the left side. It'll go foul, and we'll stay at 2-2. So two balls, two strikes, one out. Runner at second. That's Boatner, who singled out to the gap in right and then stole second without an issue. And this one hit to the left side, and it's going to go foul. So Henry right now doing a good job of keeping the at-bat alive here. See if she can find a way to win the battle here, or can Meadows find out number two of the inning. Patterson is on deck for ICC. So waiting the 2-2 offering. That one drifts high, 3-2 now. The count will go full. We're in the bottom of the sixth inning. ICC leading this one 8-2. Seeing if they could pick up some insurance runs here in the bottom half of the sixth. There's one going to the left side of the infield. Shortstop. Can't find it. That's going to be a hit. Henry had laid that one out.
Indians, center fielder number one, McKenzie Patterson.
As the third baseman kind of dived at it that time. Couldn't come up with it. And so now this will be Patterson. Or actually, excuse me, this will be a new batter coming in. This will be Haley Moody.
Haley Moody.
So Moody will come into bat for the first time today. She'll have runners at first and second with one out. She'll be replacing Patterson, who was 0 for 1 on the day. She was hit by a pitch, walked, and did score two runs. So Moody will come into bat here for the Indians. That pitch inside corner for a strike to Moody. Indians with 8 hits on the afternoon here so far. 3 for East Mississippi. This one fouled off. 0-2 now is the count here to Moody. They're in the fifth inning with baseball. ICC leading that one 11-4. That's down at Scuba. Awaiting the 0-2 pitch here to Moody. Meadows slings that one across. Not a bad spot to miss. See if she can get her to chase one. If she did make contact with it, just would have been a foul ball. But good eye on the part of Moody to hold off on that one. 1-2 now is the count. Reaches down. Third baseman. Throw over. Are actually lined out to the third baseman. Now the throw across the way will allow the run to score. And ICC does get that insurance run. So L5 on the play, on the line out. And then Boatner scores on the error. And Henry advances all the way over to third on the error as well. So ICC getting some more fresh faces in the game right now.
Now batting for the Lady Indians, number 27, Lexi Brown.
So now Lexi Brown will come to the plate. Batting with two outs in the inning. A runner at third. ICC takes advantage of that throwing error on that double play attempt that allowed Boatner to come around to score from second, and Henry advanced from first to third. So Brown will stand in, takes that first pitch high for a ball. Two outs in the inning. ICC leads this one 9-2. Here's the thing, if ICC scores this run, it's ball game. Brown rips it, and that's going to do it. Brown will get credited for a double, and ICC will pick up the win 10-2. So an RBI double off the bat of Brown.
Your final score.
And ICC wins it by the final score of 10-2. We'll take a quick break, come back with the Renaissance Bank postgame report right after this here on the ICC Sports Network.
Playing on tour takes years of dedication, hours of practice, focused precision, and nerves of steel. That's how you become great at the game, but not how you should bank. That's why Allie Ewing chose Renaissance Bank. Their easy-to-use app makes banking a breeze, no matter where she is. Renaissance Bank, understanding you.
In Searcy, Arkansas, a young man says, "I love you," for the first time, but his girlfriend doesn't quite hear. In Franklin, Tennessee, a boy encounters his first pickle. And in Kyle, Texas, after a mission for tots, cousins realize they're a long way from Kyle, Texas. One day, many people, millions of orders. This is Howie Sonic.
Why settle for a checking account that just holds your money? Renaissance Rewards Extra gives you so much more. Like savings at more than 400,000 retailers, 24/7 roadside assistance, a cell phone protection plan worth up to $400, $25 in ATM fee refunds per monthly cycle, and a great interest rate when you meet 3 easy qualifications. Get extra today at rewardsextra.com. Renaissance Bank, understanding you. Member FDIC.
And welcome back as ICC picks up the run rule victory here in game one over East Mississippi. This is the Renaissance Bank postgame report. ICC wins it by the final score of 10-2 here in game one. Let's take a look back at some final stats here. Let's look at the final line for ICC. 10 runs, 9 hits, 1 error. For East Mississippi, 2 runs, 3 hits, and 4 errors. For East Mississippi, there are 3 hits. One of them belongs to Kirkland. She had a single in the first inning. Pritchett had a double in the first inning. And then the other hit belongs to Maggie Meadows. That was in the fourth. She also stole a base and scored a run. For ICC, Hannah Henry had 3 hits on the afternoon. She scored 3 runs and stole a base. She also reached on an error. She had 4 runs scored on the afternoon. Mackenzie Patterson was 0 for 1 on the day. She was hit by a pitch, walked, scored twice. She was replaced once at bat by Haley Moody. She lined out, so she was 0 for 1 on the day. Kara Hayes on the afternoon was 2 for 2. She had an RBI or 2 run double and an RBI single. She also scored a run. She also had a sac fly back in the first inning that drove in a run. And then it was Lexi Brown who came in with an RBI double to walk it off there in the bottom of the sixth inning. Caroline Clark was 1 for 3. She had a 2 run single and she scored a run. Haley Alberson was 1 for 2 on the day, had a sacrifice fly and an RBI. She also singled. Connor Stevens was 0 for 2 on the day, did reach on an error, and did have a sacrifice bunt. Rain Rippey on the day, 0 for 2 with a sacrifice fly. Madison Jenkins on the day, 0 for 2. It was Skate Thompson coming in. She was 0 for 1. And then Katie Boatner was 1 for 2 with a walk and 2 runs scored and a stolen base. ICC improves to 22-3, 8-3 in conference play. East Mississippi falls to 4-24, 0-9 in conference play. The tough luck loser today was Lakin Firth. Hope she's okay after having a line drive hit right back to her. She falls to 4-13 on the year. The winner this afternoon for ICC was Madison Jenkins. Harrison did come in to pitch, did not allow a hit, struck out 3 of 5 batters faced. It was not a safe situation there for Harrison. So we do got to name our Samstown Market star of the game, and I'm going to have to give that one to Hannah Henry. Henry reached base all 4 times today. She was 3 for 4 with 3 singles. She did reach on an error, scored 4 runs today. 4 of the 10 runs scored there by Henry. So she is our Sonic star of the game. You're taking a look back at some of the Little Caesars instant replays here from game one. Remember, when you want something hot and ready, stop by Little Caesars right here in Fulton. This is the Renaissance Bank postgame report. Visit rewardsextra.com to learn more about Renaissance Bank's rewards extra checking accounts that offers things like roadside assistance, cell phone insurance, over 400,000 discounts, along with the great rates, and so much more. our Samstown Market Star of the Game, brought to you by Samstown Market, located in Mantachie. Sam Ferris and the rest of the crew at Samstown Market proudly serve some of the best meats and produces around. They also have a wide variety of specialty items. Stop by and visit Samstown Market, located at 3325 North Highway 371, or as I like to say, right there in the heart of Mantachie. ICC wins it 10-2 in Game 1. We'll be back in about 10 to 15 minutes with Game 2 here on the ICC Sports Network.
Why settle for a checking account that just holds your money? Renaissance Rewards Extra gives you so much more, like savings at more than 400,000 retailers, 24/7 roadside assistance, a cell phone protection plan worth up to $400, $25 in ATM fee refunds per monthly cycle, and a great interest rate when you meet 3 easy qualifications. Get extra today at rewardsextra.com. Renaissance Bank, understanding you. Member FDIC.